Thank you once again for joining us as we continue to study through this important subject of worship. We remember that we studied through Acts 2 and verse 42, and it reads, "And they continually devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, to fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer." Today we're going to be studying the subject of the breaking of bread, or the communion. Now we read about the communion when the Lord instituted it in the books of Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And then when we go over to 1 Corinthians, we read where Paul once again reiterates what the Lord taught concerning the breaking of bread or the communion. Notice what we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 and starting in verse 23. "For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" We notice that the Lord instituted the communion, the Lord's Supper, during the Passover feast. And so in our first reading here, we notice that Jesus took some bread. Now that bread would have of necessity have been unleavened bread. And notice what Jesus says about the bread. He said, "This is my body, which is for you." The bread represents the body of Christ that was sacrificed on the cross. So whenever we partake of it, we recognize and remember Christ's death on the cross. And then we saw in verse 25, "In the same way he took the cup, saying, 'This covenant is, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.'" So as the bread represented Christ's body, so the cup represents the new covenant. This is not an unusual thing. We remember at the time of Noah and the flood, God gave a representation of the covenant he gave to Noah in the form of the rainbow. Here in the New Testament, the representation of the New Testament is the cup. And we also recognize that the cup was filled with grape juice, fruit of the vine. Matthew, Mark, and Luke all talk about this. And we're told that that represents Christ's blood. So on the Lord's table, when we partake in the communion, there is the bread, which represents the body, there's the cup that represents the new covenant, and there's the grape juice, the fruit of the vine, that represents Christ's blood that was shed for us. And we finished off our reading, "For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Well, how often do we partake in the Lord's Supper? It's something, obviously, that has to be done often, but how often? Well, we notice in Acts 20 and verse 7, the habit of the Christians in the first century, the habit, the tradition, the God-given tradition that we have to follow. It says in Acts 20 and 7, "On the first day of the week, when we were gathered together to break bread, Paul began talking to them. Intending to leave the next day, he prolonged his message until midnight." This is the breaking of bread, the communion. It was done on the first day of the week. How often do we have the first day of the week? Well, it comes around every week. Every first day of the week, we have a pattern of partaking in the communion, the breaking of bread. And as we read in 1 Corinthians, as often as we eat the bread and drink the cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. We do this in remembrance of Christ's death and all that that means. The fact that he died for the forgiveness of our sins. The fact that in his death it brought into effect the new covenant. Because of his death burial and resurrection, we can look forward to the resurrection, and we can look forward to our eternal home in heaven. All these things are tied up in the communion, a most important part of our worship to the Lord. If you have any more questions about this important subject, we'd really welcome them, and we ask you to write your questions in the comments below. Until next time, take care, and goodbye for now.